Work on yourself. Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Anna, and this channel is about Germany and especially work, study and life in Germany. Today I want to talk about actually study and potentially work in Germany, and in particular about master program in Germany, how you can get a job after master program. As many foreigners come to Germany to study master and with the aim to work in Germany, so they not really come to Germany because of great education and low cost. They really want to work in Germany, and so the master program, it's like a bridge to get the, of course, additional qualifications and to work long term in Germany. But I want to make a disclaimer, because that shouldn't be your goal. You should really focus on the benefits of studying in Germany, of studying a master, which you can do in English in many universities and for so many qualifications for free. The cost of living in Germany is lower than in other Western countries. So really focus on benefits and not much of getting the job, because not everyone will get a job. And if you really focus on getting a job and you're not gonna get one in the end, then you will need to leave the Germany. It will be very pity, but that's why you shouldn't focus on it. As I mentioned, not everybody get a job after master. The job is not guaranteed. That's why I'm making this video, to give you some tips and everything what you need to know in order to get a job after master's in Germany. The German immigration system is very friendly. For this reason, they give foreigners 18 months after completion of master program to find a job in Germany. So you can extend your resident permit for students for 18 months and seek for a job. In this time, usually people find a job, and after they can convert their student resident permit in other kind of resident permit. There are two currently available resident permits. It's a EU blue card, more high level of resident permit, and a usual employment resident permit. EU blue card is really made for people with a high income, because it has high salary as a minimal requirement. For people with a normal degree, it's 55,000 per year required income. And for people who are in the STEAM professions, STEAM is science, engineering, techniques and mathematics, they have different requirements, 33,000 euro per year, which is not that hard to get as 55. So if you study STEAM professions, you have higher chances to apply and receive the EU blue card than if you have some kind of different profession. Employment visa, German employment visa, doesn't require any minimal salary, so basically everyone who has a job offer can apply. And the benefits of being a student in Germany is that usually when you apply for your normal employment visa, the German government, German Federal Employment Office, Agentur für Arbeit, they will prove if there are some other candidates available in Germany or in European Union for this particular position you apply for. So if there are other applicants for this position, this job, you in most cases would not receive the visa, and so you will need to leave the country. And when you study in Germany, wherever it's a bachelor or master, they don't do this approval. They don't seek for other European Union candidates or German candidates. They will give you approval automatically and you will receive the employment visa. So these two possible visas are available for you after you find a job in Germany, and of course it's only after completion master. When you want to work during the master program, you don't apply for any additional permits or residence permits. You just work not more than 20 hours per week, but still it's possible to work. So when you apply for this extension of your resident permit, of your student resident permit, you need to also provide some additional documents. You need to provide your health insurance. Now you need new health insurance, not the student one. You need a real health insurance, which can be more pricey, which will be more pricey. Next, you need to prove your funds. Now your funds can be proven in terms of working contract. If you work somewhere and you already receive money, this can be your proof, or you have funds in your banking account. These are two usual ways to prove it. And the last is common requirement, is a proof of accommodations. I suppose you lived somewhere this 2 years of your master program, so you just provide the same rental apartment contract for your apartment. This would be your proof of accommodations. The main difference between EU blue card and employment visa is that permanent residency possibilities. So you will have possibility to receive a permanent residency in both cases with both visas, but with EU blue card you can receive it already after 33 months, when with a normal employment visa you will need to wait 4 years till you will get it. Now you know which visas are available for you. Now we are gonna talk which chances do you have when getting the job in Germany after master, because you need to estimate your chances. You need to look at this very realistically, because not everyone has the same chances in Germany. The first is, of course, your major. What did you study in Germany? Which was your major for master? As I mentioned, the STEM professions are always in a top level. They are top hire. They're employers really like to hire STEM students in Germany. You can even get a job already during your studies. If you have some different degree, some different major, it's already more difficult. Most difficult majors would be humanities. If you're in humanities majors such as like history or politics, archaeology, all related to these areas which are not really specify you and qualify you for some kind of profession, some kind of job, these are hardest to get in Germany, because there are already competition and people are already struggling to find a job in humanities in Germany. The next factor is your country of origin. I know it sounds discriminating, but it's true, because not everyone has the same chances, and it's very depends on your country of origin, because Germany will look which country is a priority country, which country is a lower priority. When you apply for a job, it's already discriminatory, because for example, employers always would prefer people from Europe, from European Union, because it's free for movement. You don't need to apply for visas. There are usually not big difference in culture, and languages can be learned as well. Many in Europe learn German. Most of them speak, of course, English, and you study in English, so, and you usually don't have very strong accent as you would be from a faraway country with a very different culture. You will need to apply for visas in Germany, and employers also understand if you're from really far away and you used to work differently. For them it would be harder to integrate you in a culture, in a company culture, and they would just have more work with a candidate from far away. If you compare candidates for a job, for example, from Russia and someone from Africa, the country like Gambia or something, you can see that culture differences are huge between Gambia and Germany than with Russia and Germany. The people also speak English in both countries, of course, if we study in Germany, but people from Gambia maybe have stronger accent, or maybe they have other struggles. It's of course very depends on the country, but employers will look also on this point, and they would rather hire a person from not far away with some kind of similarities than from totally different place. There are also some countries which have high priority in Germany, such as US, Australia, South Korea, Israel, Canada, New Zealand. Nationals of these countries don't have many problems in Germany to be hired, because it's already in the priority list. The visas are more easy for them in Germany. The culture differences are also not that high, and the working environment we're used to in their home country is similar than in Germany, so that's why German companies would not question much before hire the American than they would question before we will hire someone from India. The next, of course, important factor is your fluency in languages, especially in German language. Do you speak language or you don't speak language at all? Of course, candidates with some knowledge in German, if it's even like small and they just started, would be treated differently than a person without any knowledge of German. But it again depends on the position. If your position doesn't require you to speak German at all, it's probably doesn't play a role, but if you have a mostly German colleagues, if you maybe need to speak sometimes German, of course German language will benefit you, or absence of the German skills would be seen as a negatives in your CV. If you know that your job potentially can require you to speak German, start to learn German of course as soon as possible, maybe in the beginning of a master program. If not, if you really like working as a programmer, as a software engineer or something related to this, maybe you don't need German at all. Or maybe you speak also different languages, some European language, maybe French, Spanish, or Italian, because Germany works with these countries and there are many companies who have branches in other European countries. So if you speak one of these languages, it's also beneficial for you. And of course, if you're native English speaker, it's already a different story. If you speak English fluently, it's definitely will also be a great point on your CV and for your German employers. The next advice for finding a job after your master is that you should to work already during your master's. Take some part-time jobs, take maybe a job possibly related to your field of expertise, and maybe also in company which you see as your future employer, as your potential full-time employer, because it happens quite often when companies hire someone for part-time, and in the end we will hire someone for full-time after we finish their studies. So by working already during your master's, you will increase your chances drastically because you gain working experience. You also learn how Germans work, how German companies function. You will also, of course, show yourself to a potential full-time employer. We will see you in work. You can prove yourself. You will also, of course, get new knowledge, get new experience, and it's also, of course, beneficial for your CV that you have already experience in some German company. Even if you leave afterwards, it's only beneficial, and really do it if you have time. If you can manage to work at least maybe one day per week, it's still great. The other way you can go about this is also to gain work experience before your master's. In your home country or in Germany, you can get a job related to your field and have some experience, so you can prove also yourself and you can show your future employer that you are not just fresh from bachelor to master. So you finished your bachelor, has some experience, maybe 1, 2, 3 years of experience, and then you start your master with already great knowledge in your area. And it's again great for your CV, great for your future employer in Germany, and for you because you gain experience. More experience you have, the better chances you have. Expand your network in Germany. Your network is your net worth. By living in Germany these 2 years during your master, try to get to know right people in your industry. Go to events, talk to your professors, try to stay in contact with them so they can recommend you to someone. Talk to your fellow students, your colleagues at university. Maybe we will give you some contacts. Maybe they know someone, they can help you. Always try to communicate with right people, try to build connections with right people who are in your industry. And if you have the right people, it's always, of course, only helpful for you than not having anyone. The next is learn German, you know, because you're already in Germany. Why not to learn German? It will be easier for you when you're there. You're studying at university, you're studying with Germans maybe, or you have German friends, you can practice with them. Because learning German, maybe you will end up learning this anyway in your career or in the future. Why not to do this as soon as possible? I would start to learn German from beginning of the master, so I already know something. I have some knowledge in the end, so I can also put it in my CV and be more secure in the job interviews, and maybe even do it already in German. Because every employer, of course, will like to see that the candidate speaks German, and we will see you are serious about Germany, you are serious to work in Germany, to stay here long term, so we can also be sure that you're not just jumping from country to country. Learning German, it's just like my advice for everyone, I guess. Because in the end, if you have great notes in your master program, some experience, work experience, you already worked during your master's, then maybe you can get a job also without German language. But if you're just fresh after bachelor and master, you're not having great notes, you don't have any experience, what's the point for an employer to hire you and not to hire somebody from Germany or some other foreigner who has this experience, the German language, who also worked in German company. Like, you need to be realistic. There are not really like jobs everywhere. Everybody invites you to work in German companies. The master graduate, it can be challenging because if you don't speak German and you don't have experience, there are not many companies who would be really interested, except they really need workers and it's very demanded field, then probably yes, but unless it is, probably not. And the last my tip, just keep going, apply for jobs, because you are not gonna receive the job from a second application. Some foreigners can send 100 applications and then we will get answers, then we will get invitations for interviews. It's not like you also will get the answers for all your applications. People just ignore, you know. Not many companies are open to hire the foreigners. Some of them really conservative and some really want to have Germans employees, and you know, your chances also would be decreased by the factors like I mentioned before: experience, German language, and your major, of course. So just don't be discouraged, because this is the last what you can do. Never lose the hope and take your time. You have 18 months and start to look for a job, start to build connection as soon as possible. As soon as you start your master program, be proactive and not reactive. I hope this was helpful for you if you are studying master program in Germany, or you're thinking about starting master program and working and in Germany. Again, that shouldn't be your main goal. Of course, it's nice to have the job in Germany. Just think about it, what you can offer German employers, so we will hire you instead of Germans, and work on yourself. Okay guys, that was all for today. Thank you for watching and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss next video. I will see you next one.